Well, good day, Tubes. How's she going? So, if you can hear behind me, so I'm making some funny noises back here. Yeah, today is Scrap Metal Thursday. Let's think about that. And we're just gonna do some smushing on this feller. But kind of wanted to see if she'll still spin for us. And maybe we'll do like a spin cycle, squash the dryer, washer machine. There she goes. Alright, my weapon of the day today is Ripper Tooth against freaking spinning washer machine. So anyways, we'll wait till she gets geared up real good. There she goes. And we'll start smooshing. Well, there we go. That wasn't too bad. And yeah, I didn't want that pressure washer either. It was freaking junk. Stupid thing. So it's going to the scrap. I know there's a bunch of copper in there, but you know what? I can't be bothered to separate it and stuff. They can freaking do that for the $3 I'd get out of it. I'm not really too concerned about it. Core, don't need that either. I just need rid of the junk. But anyways, still got some good tires. Anybody need some good used freaking rubbery tires? No? Okay. And yeah, that washing machine didn't fare too well, did it? She don't look so much like a washing machine now as it did before. So, well, it looks like we still got a door intact here, almost. I guess it's mostly plastic, so I'm not gonna take it out. Stupid thing. Oh, look at the size of that spring. That might be worth saving. Holy. Oh, I know where that would have been from. That would have been from the drum and stuff here. So there's your nice big heavy concrete weights and them things too. That's probably stainless. It's probably worth keeping, but no. She's going and getting rid of this crap. And there's looks like the water heater thing that worked really good, not anymore, but that was probably from the sanitation cycle, you know, where you could crank the stuff on, it would like melt up the heat real good, or melt up the water real good. What else we got here? That looks like a hunk of cast. Oh, that's from the pressure washer. And it's like a nice aluminum pulley or something. Scrap. And what else we got here? There's a capacitor probably under here. Yep. Capacitors. Put that in. Oh, there's another spring, but it looks like a stretcher. Yeah. Scrap that one. But anyways, that's about mostly it, I guess. Alright, so the old dryer's been ticking me off pretty good too, so see you later, dryer. I guess that wasn't too bad for squash. Look at all the money! Ha! Sweet, I even get paid for freaking... Holy! Enough there to buy coffee, darn. Well, maybe not. Holy cow, you can tell how much this has been used. Oh, there's $2 and change. $3 probably in quarters. Holy crap. I didn't even think there'd be money in there. Look at that. A little dirty, but whoops. Spend a little time in the pocket, she'll clean right up. But anyways, I guess we pretty much mushed this down. I wonder where the heck that money was sitting. That's interesting. Very interesting. So yeah, we kind of mushed this all up pretty good and got the drum all smushed up and pretty dense, I guess. That's not bad. And yeah, did you like the backhoe skills of ripping off the buttons first? I was trying for the lint trap, but ended up popping the cover off. So we kind of failed at that, but oh well. Hey, there's a instruction doohies here or something. Oh, wiring diagram doohie. Oh, there, that's what's wrong with her. This switch here screwed or something maybe. I bet ya. Oh well, a little more scrap metal. Find places for everything. And we got, of course, a bunch of crap inside to load up yet too, but probably won't do that till the morning or something. Gotta throw that in the back of the truck, I guess, 'cause I can't lift that box. It's just a little bit too heavy. And I'm sure if I look around, I'll find a little bit more here and there and everywhere. So, but very good. Scrap metals days. Well, just cleaning up the ground here, I found something pretty cool. Have a look at these. Perfect little lint balls. I guess they're rolling around in there. Keep gathering stuff, you know, and different sizes. Like, perfectly round. There's one here looks like, whoops. He was just lint ball in training, getting started. And yeah, this must be rolling around gathering stuff. This one's almost perfect though. I can't believe how smooth it is, eh? Lint ball smooth. I think that's pretty funny. Whoa, stay lint ball. Stay. Well, it's pulling a bunch of stuff off my shelf in there, and a whole bunch of stuff all of a sudden fell off, and this thing was one of them, so it's not good for him. It did still work, but after falling from, it was up sort of where the pump is there, wha-bam, onto the cement. So I think we're just gonna give her the old 1-2-1-2. Ready? Here we go. Well, short work of that feller. Look at the thickness of the glass on this thing. Holy, that's got to be half inch thick anyways. Lovely, eh? Not too much else really exciting in here, but let's dig through the pile of shrapnel here and see if anything that we recognize at all. Well, it's a smashed up board. There's a bit of scrap metal. A little bit. That up there, a little bit. Probably the only metal in it. Oh, there's another bit there. She's attached to the old VCR though. That's what that was. That was a TV VCR combo. Oh, speaker's still good, maybe. Sorta. Oh, there's the tube thing. Look at the copper windings on that, eh? That's probably worth about 18 cents right there. Holy! But anyways, I'm just going to scoop it right into the big dumpster here. Well, I guess that's about it for today. I just wanted to kind of get a bit of that bigger stuff kind of smushed down and stuff, you know, onto the trailer, and she's good to go now. And this crap here we can throw in the truck, I guess, tomorrow. Throw her in there. I guess tomorrow, if got nothing else going, I don't think, will be Scrap Metal Friday, and we'll actually take that crap into the place just outside of town here, and probably get like $5 for it, and then be able to buy a coffee, you know, and we'll be all looking super good. So spend, you know, 2-3 hours today messing around, and about $18 in gas driving there and back to get $5 worth of scrap metal. Sounds like a plan to me. So, but anyways, seems to be the way that works. You know, a lot of guys just go diehard crazy at scrap metal and stuff, and they're not really getting much by the time you figure it out. You know, like, I don't know. I don't mind doing it, it's just with my stuff, but I don't go out of my way to pick up other people's crap, you know? Like, holy, I ain't got time for that. You know, you'd have to be getting like 70, 80 cents a pound to make it worth anything, you know? The price of gas nowadays, that's not worth it. So I just do my little bit, clean up my crap, and drive on. But anyways, we got a little something we thought about that compressor pump. Remember the one that we tried the other day there, and I didn't really like it much and stuff? Well, let's go have a look. Well, the plan was, we were thinking, actually, my buddy Landkid and I were talking the other night there. That's the fella that's coming, next Monday. Holy, gotta run to the airport, pick up Landy. But anyways, we were sort of discussing the other night there what to kind of do with this thing, because I didn't seem to really like it in here too much, you know, and stuff. So we were kind of thinking, what about maybe throwing this on like some kind of three-point hitch kind of trailery kind of lifted up and go kind of thing, you know? You could mount this with, you know, like the shaft coming out of the back of the tractor, driving a pulley or something here that's going to have to be all mounted with barrelings and stuff and whatever you do to mount that, driving the pulley off the three-point hitch, and then sort of back maybe on this corner or whatever, something you could have like one of those big tanks like Iron Man gave me, you know, something kind of sort of like that. It's not very big for that big pump, but she wouldn't be long filling, so I think that would be maybe kind of a winter idea, projecty maybe kind of thing. We could figure out something along the lines of that, you know, and say like we're sitting driving on the tractor here, and then just behind you want some air powered up, okay, pull your dewey on, away she goes, right? It starts filling into your, into your tank. So the only thing I'm thinking that would be wrong with it is it wouldn't shut off, right? It would have to keep going until this got to, I think that's 175 PSI blow off dewey. That I'm not certain on, but it would and then stop, and then build up again, and then, or you could just shut the PTO off, whatever, right? So, kind of thinking, pipe dreaming it right now, but, you know, instead of maybe taking her back, we might rig her up something like that. It'd be kind of cool, I think. I'm pretty sure the little green tractor and the PTO would run that, no problem. And we'd have to figure out gearing and stuff, you know, like if you put a bigger pulley on here, and it would drive this thing kind of faster, build your air faster, but then it might be too hard on the pump and stuff, right? So it'd be nice to kind of do her so you could just, I don't know, gear up the tractor a bit, and it would make it go, which it will, but you don't want to overgo this thing, right? But you don't want to undergo it either, I guess. So, but we'll have to figure that out when we do that. So we will have to probably make this dewey with the pulley here that comes off the shaft solid mount, and we can maybe put this thing maybe on like some in the plate, say underneath where it's going to sit on some slotted dewey, so we can move it back and forth. So if we're changing pulleys and stuff, it's not going to make a huge difference. I think it'd be probably better to keep the shaft solid and then move this thing. So and then once you get her figured out where you want her, just bolt her down and Bob's your uncle. So I don't really need like a portable air compressor thing like that, but you know, wouldn't hurt. That wasn't sort of my intention when I first bought this thing, but you know, that's maybe what she's going to end up turning into. So, But yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a hundred and maybe it's a hundred. It's got to be 175 psi at least, because this thing's rated for 175. So that's probably where that blows off at. Now, there's another one there, but I don't know what, I can't read the thingy on it, so I don't know what they're actually rated for. Usually they'll tell you on it, but these are probably just cheapy Chinese ones. There's a number there too. 00P, 200 pounds. So that blows off at 200 pounds maybe. Holy, that's a lot. That's lots. I don't know what that one says. Looks like 70P, so I don't know, but 200 pounds, holy. Well, I could tell you, that's a pretty good spring on that, and yeah, that's a bit slacker spring, so that sort of makes sense then. So that's basically got to build 200 PSI, and then it's got enough to, so we could do that, but it'll scare the frick out of someone when the thing blows, you know. But you'd have to put a gauge on her, I guess, somewhere. Probably wouldn't even be bad to put a gauge maybe even right in here, so we'll maybe do a, put a little nipply thing there out to a T with that, and then I don't know, maybe screw in a gauge there so you can kind of tell what your system pressure's at and stuff. So but I think maybe that's not too bad of an idea. Now this valvey thing here, I do kind of understand the way it somewhat works now with you're supposed to actually have that blow off thing in the line, but and it'll just kind of bleed off all until it's gone right in the line from the line to the tank, which kind of sort of makes sense. But I was getting so frustrated the other day, I wasn't really thinking, you know, kind of outside the box. So this is actually working right, you know. Basically I was somewhat simulating it when I was turning my tank off. That would be like your one-way valve, say, right? And it slowly just bleed off. So this is actually working right when you stop to think about it. But yeah, I was getting so frustrated the other day messing around with belts and frickin' pulleys and stuff that I wasn't thinking of that. I'm like, why in the frick is this thing leaking? That was ticking me off, you know. But technically that is right. That is what it's supposed to do. So as soon as this thing stops, which it did, you must open a valve there and then it starts to leak the air off. So say your line's coming out here into your tank. If we put the one-way valve so the air can get in but not back out, it'll, anything from there into the line, all the rest of this will just go till it's done, right? So sort of kind of makes sense. But yeah, so that's maybe an idea for the, I don't know, winter project. I don't really know which one I want to tackle first. This one's not really super imperative that I get this done right kind of right away, because I don't, like I say, don't really need a air compressor. I never sort of really had a need for one outside of you know, the shop area here. So I don't know, we might get that going later on this winter or something, and mess around with that a little bit. But there's a couple more other projects too I want to do. Really wouldn't mind making a snowplow blade for the big tractor, but that's a frick of a lot of work. Stopping to think about it, even just building the plow part, you know, sort of like I built that other one, I'd probably cut strips and then glue them onto these other pieces I got already cut here, which I was originally going to use. I got all these fellers here, right? Now there's 1, 2, 3, 4. I could cut one here, 5. And I think I've got the outsides of those ones are 6, 7, 8, 9. So, you know, she could be 8 foot wide, 10 foot wide, I don't know. But what else was there? I think that's mostly about it today. Yeah, or so tomorrow we'll be probably doing some scrap metal and stuff. I'll gather a bit more crap up and then we'll head her out and see how much to give us for it. Probably won't be very much, but you know, that's the way she works. So but I got some crap to take, you know. Probably could dig up more stuff here and there and everywhere, but I know there's some in the other side there too I might as well take and get rid of as well. So but I think pretty much all the big stuff is loaded except that blue box. I have to take that piece by piece, maybe, or take a bit out of her, like the big brake drums and the rotors and stuff add up pretty darn fast, you know. So, and I'm pretty sure I've got some more stuff here somewhere. Turn the lights off here. Pretty sure in behind this plywood. Let me just pull some of this junk back. I thought I had some more brake drums or something down inside of there. I guess maybe I threw them in that box already. I can't remember. I don't really see anything else. I know there's a couple more barrelings and stuff, but I might have thrown them in too. So yeah, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 brake rotors there. So I don't know, they're probably 20 pounds a piece maybe. So that's not too bad. But I don't know anything else. I was thinking of throwing my old exhaust pipe out and stuff, but maybe I will. I don't know. You think I'm going to change it back? Not probably, but not probably likely. So yeah, maybe by tomorrow that'll end up in the back. So yeah, I should take that whole freaking ATV and throw it in too, but they don't like the tires, so stupid thing. But man, that one was all greasy. I just put my hand in my pocket. Isn't that nice? Oh well. Sweet, look what else I found, a freaking lint Smartie. It's like a freaking Smartie shaped out of lint. That is pretty cool. I don't know how many times those things have tumbled around in there and tumbled around and tumbled around, but holy crap, eh? Oh yeah, we got in the front of the garage there too, just remembering there, we got that pail of stuff we chopped off for when we were doing the bridge stuff here. So we got that to take, and there's some car rims there. The ones we squashed off that time, and oh, I'm sure there's something else. I just can't remember now. But yeah, so we'll be taking all that, I guess, in. That'll add up to a little bit. That I-beam stuff gets pretty heavy, so. But anyways, I guess that's probably it for today. Gonna head her home before the sun's down again. Holy crap, so depressing. But anyways, you guys have a good day. We're walking halfway across the new bridge. Maybe we can get enough money to gather up tomorrow from scrap metal to buy us the rest of the wood. That wouldn't be a bad idea, eh? I think I'm gonna go this side. And then, yeah, we can get those painted up with that stuff and get banging on the rest of the boards here over to the corner here, and she'll be good to, well, you know, still gotta fill in a bit of dirt and stuff to make a nice little ramp up to everything here, but probably here I'll, you know, do a out to kind of there so you don't even really notice it, right? But yeah, that's gonna be pretty good. So oh yeah, I was in here too, and the other day they're always waiting for my vault to show up from that funeral. I was in here with the forklift, man. Oh man, that's a handy attachment, let me tell you. And cleaned up all the old crap out of there and the old tree that we had to bust out to get out of the hole here, and cleaned up a bunch of other old junk and the rest of the old bridge that was, you know, hauled up over there kind of thing. Just scooped under it, picked her up, and gone. It went perfect. So yeah, still got this tree here, and then you can see pretty much those two fellers there should probably come out. You could smash into that if you happen to whipping across here and forgot there was a tree there, so probably have to knock those things out of there. That one's a freaking, well, this one here is a one of them cheesy cottony wood things anyway, so it's probably gonna be dead the next year anyways. But I mean, that cedar one's not bad over there, but she'd make a good mailbox post, that one. Holy, that's what I use for our house there. And oh man, it'll outlast me, I'm sure. But anyways, yeah, we're gonna head her home, and won't be much else going on today. I think I'm gonna go and get all this rendered up and do some work on Farm Sim Saturday for you. It's for Saturday there. She's started a little bit of it, but oh yeah, too, I moved all these bales and stuff that were here, and moved that roll of foam stuff over between the dewey there, you see over beside the shed, and moved the those two bales out of the way for winter time, just, you know, up over past the gate here kind of thing. So I love that fork. I'll tell you, I should have one of those years ago too. But I was having a good forking time that day. We forked everything out of the way here and moved a bench out of the way that was in the way back there for wintertime plowing and stuff. I've always not liked it there for wintertime when I'm plowing snow. It would be nice to get right through and clear that area right out, but never could because of the stupid bench was there. So it just went dink, gone. Just like that. You can't do that with the bucket, right? So. But yeah, so anyways, that's it for today. In the dark again here, holy crap. But anyways, have a good night. thanks for watching, and we'll catch you tomorrow. We'll head her out to load up the rest of that scrap metal and head her out to scrap metal place, see if we can get some lumber money. Maybe it's, might as well, if we get enough, come right back to the Home Depot after that, grab some lumber. So, and what did I think? Another 13, I think. Yeah, something around there. So, well, maybe if we get enough, we'll maybe do that. So, anyways, have a good night. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you tomorrow for Scrap Metal Frickin' Friday.